Hi, I'm Tim Garrison, and welcome to Gettin Inside. And I'd like to introduce you to one of the fiercest ladies in the R&B scene. She's not necessarily new, but she may be new to you.
Well, my name is Ledisi, and what I'm told from my parents is that it's a Nigerian word from the Yoruba culture. It's in a Yoruba song, and it means to bring forth, to come here. It's Ledisi.
Ledisi. Her name and her music is a true OG. Her music collaborates jazz, R&B, soul, and blues.
Come here, baby, let me do your hair. Tell me who about your worries and your cares. Explain to me exactly what you need. I'm here for you and I ain't a please. Ooh, I got your back when those fools be talking smack. Cause they jealous of this thing we got. I'm the one to be giving you.
Recently, Ledisi has been nominated for 2 Grammy Awards, but struggled for more than 10 years as an indie artist. Now, in this interview, I asked Ledisi to guide me through her life's path in music, also including singing with the New Orleans Symphony Orchestra at the age of 8.
In New Orleans, when I was younger, we'd always have music around the house, so my mother and my stepfather put me in programs that were around in school, and I had a teacher named Ms. Ziegler, and she went ahead and enrolled me into the NOCA, New Orleans Symphony Chorus for the Youth.
Now, what was your personality like back then when you was a little girl?
Oh, man. I was very shy. I was very, very skinny with big eyes. I was very awkward, and I got beat up after school every day. I don't know why. I don't remember. I was always the darkest one and just odd looking all the time. My sisters are very fair and long, pretty hair, and I would just look like the oddball in the bunch.
In recent shows, you know, I've had discussions in the past about skin color. You know, if it ain't light, it ain't right. The blacker the berry, the sweeter the juice. Well, how do you feel about your skin now?
You know, I love my skin right now. I'm so happy to be in my skin. I started loving myself towards the end of my record, probably 2-3 years ago. It took a long time, you know, to start loving myself. I had a lot of people tell me I'm not pretty enough. It was tough.
Haters. I wonder what they have to say now. Ledisi, you seem to be a woman that's in control. You know, I saw you in the Bay Area while I was visiting alumni. And girlfriend, when I saw you take the stage, I mean, you took the stage.
How y'all doing? You feeling good? Where y'all been?
When I sing and it's live, I become this other thing. I become this old lady preacher or sassy Bessie or something. You know, the audience is my congregation and I just do whatever, and I'm real and honest, and I pointed out the things that people don't like to talk about. So that's what artists are supposed to do anyway, to take people away from what's regular. And I love that. Live is just a personal relationship between you and your audience, and you get to sing and be, and sometimes we misuse that power.
Let me hear you say it. Cause I've been here. What? Yeah, that sounds good. Come on. You feeling good? Yeah.
You know, speaking of things that make people uncomfortable or just going into new territory, you know, you did a song called Papa Loved to Love Me, and it was about sexual abuse. How did your family and friends react about this song that laid out some serious issues people normally don't talk about?
Well, yeah, that it's a true story. Everything I write, it either starts with me or it's something I've seen or whatever. But that particular song was definitely a poem that I had written years ago, and we recorded it, and I was so freaking out the whole process. I can only sing it twice.
No, please don't.
I remember it all. Yesterday, I remember praying, Jesus, won't you come my way? I remember the liquor on his breath, his hand on my thigh. I couldn't scream, all I did was cry.
So then when it finally made it into someone's hands, like my mother and family, I was worried that they were going to be mad at me because, you know, in our culture, we don't like to tell a lot of things that go on behind closed doors. And my mother loved it. Was happy that I told the truth. Sometimes you have to go through the pain to get to the healing. So I'm very proud of that I did that.
Now, Ledisi, you know I know you. I know that you're a hard worker. And it shows in your previous CDs because I hear the sweat. I hear the tears in your writing and your producing of your CDs, but the latest CD, Lost and Found, it takes you to another place where you're a lot more produced. Now, what was it like to give up some of that control, if any, and working with other producers?
Well, for me, I produced everything with the producers that are on my record. I still had a lot of control. I had started on my record before I signed with a major label. I didn't know how I was going to pay for it. These were friends of mine. We were hanging out. We didn't have a plan. Everything was just, let's just hang and write something together and Led, don't stress about it, because I was really weary of recording again. I didn't want to go back in the studio and go back into the hot seat of pressure of being an artist again. I just really wanted to just teach and be quiet, you know, and not perform. I was really done with the business, and to have finished it and to know towards the end of the record that all of this is worth it, win or lose, I just had a wonderful time making it.
Okay, the title track. Tell me about it.
Lost and Found is about being lost in the beginning and then being found towards the end of this record.
Always alone, someone come for me. Here on my own, feels like the pain lasts an eternity. Tears come no more, I wanna smile again, love again. Someone find me.
Really, during the process of everything, I put my faith, I started to align myself in faith. And once I learned that, then everything else started to become clear for me towards the end of the record. It became clear that I belong in the industry. It became clear that I deserve happiness, and I should start loving myself even more and just being happy with everything as I am. Because all this time I've been asking to be found, asking to be heard and listened to, asking for spiritual guidance. Everything just came. So when I finished, I was like, yes, you know, it was kind of like shedding old skin.
Interesting. Well, you and I both know that timing is everything. And a lot of people are finding out about you. It's obvious because of the two Grammy nominations for Best New Artist and Best New R&B Album. Now, when did you find out that you were nominated?
Well, when I got a call about the Grammy nominations, I just freaked out. I mean, my mouth just dropped and I just screamed and frantically around the house, just calling everybody I can think of. And I called my mom and she hung up on me. So it was a great experience to have that happen. I'm floored.
Ledisi, you've been in the business for a long time. Now, does it strike you kind of odd that you're being nominated for Best New Artist?
I don't know. Their definition of new is different from what everybody else thinks it is. So I'm just happy they think I belong in this category. And I'm very excited about it. I'll let others debate on that. But for me, I'm just happy to be a part of it, honestly. Nothing and no one can take this feeling away. It's exciting for me.
Well, girlfriend, I wish you good luck at the Grammys. And, of course, I want you to have a wonderful time. And, again, thanks for coming by and talking to me on Gettin Inside.
Thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate it.
Singer, songwriter, and now Grammy nominee, Ledisi. Her brand new CD, Lost and Found. If you want more information on Ledisi, you can go to her website, which is ledisi.com. And, of course, her MySpace page, which is myspace.com/Ledisi. That's our show for today. I'm Tim Garrison for Gettin Inside.